This time, no, I'll just want to focus on preparing the system security plan. A system security plan, or what we call SSP, is an essential document that outlines the security requirements and controls or an information system, because it provides a comprehensive overview of how security measures are implemented, managed, and maintained to protect the systems and its data. Preparing a system security plan is essential for ensuring that an organization's security postures aligns with regulatory requirements and best practices. The five steps, no, in preparing the SSP is to define its scope and purposes. This involves, no, identifying the system's boundaries, the data it processes, and the specific security requirements it must meet. So the purpose of SSP is to provide a clear and detailed plan that guides the implementation and maintenance of security controls throughout the system lifecycle. So a system security plan begins, no, with detailed description of the system. This includes the system names, unique identifiers. Of course, in a database, you are all familiar with the unique identifiers, either private, no, entity, no, and so on. System owner and general description of its purpose and functionality. Additionally, it should include information about the system's environment, such as the operating system, ano ba yung mga applications na available, and network components it relies on. Next, of course, is the system must be categorized based on the types of information it processes and the potential impact of a security breach. This categorization, no, helps determine the level of security controls required. So, the system's impact level, low, either moderate or high, guides the selection of appropriate security measures to protect the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of data. Once the system is categorized, the next step is to select the security controls that will be implemented. So these controls are based on the framework such as NIST, no, SP 800-53, pwede namang ISO IEC 27001, or other relevant standards. So the selected controls should address various security aspects, including access control, incident response, and system maintenance. For each security control selected, no, the SSP must provide a detailed description of how it will be implemented, because it must include specifying the technology, processes, and personnel involved in deploying and maintaining the control. Clear implementation details ensure that all stakeholders understand the roles and its responsibilities. Right after that, defining roles and responsibility is essential for the successful implementation of the SSP. The plan should outline the responsibility of system owners, security officers, administrators, and the users. This ensures accountability and provides clarity on how it's responsible, no, for various security tasks, such as monitoring, reporting, and incident response. Documentation of security controls is a key component of the SSP. This involves creating and maintaining records that demonstrate how controls are implemented, tested, and validated. So proper documentation provides evidence of compliance and facilitates audits and assessment. An SSP must include a comprehensive risk assessment that identifies the potential threats, vulnerabilities, and the impact of security incident. This assessment helps prioritize security controls based on the level of risk they mitigate. So ongoing risk management ensures that the system remains secure as new threats and vulnerabilities emerge. Incident response is a critical element of the SSP, because the plan should outline procedures for detecting, responding to, and recovering from security incidents. This includes defining communication protocols, roles, and responsibilities during an incident, as well as steps, no, for documenting and analyzing the incident to prevent future occurrence. Now, so To ensure the effectiveness of the SSP, it is essential to implement training and awareness programs. And these programs educate employees about security policies, procedures, and best practices. Now, so regular training helps foster a security conscious culture and ensures that everyone understands their role in protecting the system. Security is not one-time effort. Take note of it. But it requires continuous monitoring and maintenance because the SSP should outline procedures for regular monitoring of security controls, system performance, and compliance. This includes conducting periodic security assessment, vulnerability scans, and update to address new threats and vulnerabilities. Once the SPP is prepared, it must undergo a thorough review and approval process. This involves stakeholders from various departments, including IT, security, legal, and management. Now, their input ensures that the plan is comprehensive, accurate, and aligned with organizational goals and regulatory requirements. After approval, the SSP is implemented and integrated into the organization's overall security strategy. And this involves deploying the security controls, configuring systems according to the plan, and ensuring that all personnel are trained and aware of their responsibilities. Successful integration requires coordination and collaboration across departments. No? So, the SSP is a living document that requires ongoing evaluation and improvement. Regular reviews, again, audits and assessment help identify areas for enhancement. So as the threat landscape evolves, the SSP must be updated to incorporate new controls, technologies, and best practices, as what I mentioned. Continuous improvement ensures that the system remains secure and resilient against emerging threats. So preparing a system security plan is a comprehensive and iterative process that requires careful planning. It must be detailed documentation, and you have an ongoing maintenance. Following a structured approach, organization can ensure that their system are protected against a wide range of security threats and are compliant with relevant regulations and standards. And that was focused on the SSP.